It is now time to make your first sound on your instrument. Let's first review our posture and hand position. Sit with your feet flat on the floor with an elongated back and relaxed shoulders. Set the horn in the ready position, on its side with your left hand in the correct position, and the right hand holding the bell. Now go to playing position, bringing the mouthpiece up to your mouth with the lead pipe set at the proper downward angle. Check to be sure that the sound is not going into your body. Once you are set in playing position, double-check that your mouthpiece is placed properly, centered left to right with 2/3 upper lip and 1/3 lower lip. Now go back to ready position. For this first part of playing on your instrument, we're simply going to practice blowing all of our air into the instrument. Watch as Katie demonstrates this for us. Notice that she takes a full breath and blows all of her air back into the instrument. Her body remains still, and her shoulders remain relaxed through this process. Also notice that the mouthpiece is flush against her face and that the rim is sealed against her mouth, but she is not pressing the mouthpiece into her mouth. Now go to playing position and try this with Katie. Make sure you are set correctly and that you take a full breath. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Go to ready position. Be sure that your cheeks are not puffing and that you have no air pockets between your gums and the inside part of your mouth. You should keep your corners firm but not tense and keep your chin pointed down. Try this again with Katie. Go to playing position. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Now press pause and practice this a few times, remembering these important steps. Now let's make our first sound on the instrument. We will do this by blowing air, then letting our lips vibrate. Listen as Katie demonstrates this on the horn. As Katie demonstrates this for you on the mouthpiece visualizer, notice that her lips are touching to vibrate, but she's not pressing them together. Keep your mouth open and your teeth apart to let the air flow freely. Then let the lips be close enough to vibrate. Watch one more time as Katie performs this on the horn. Now let's try this together. Go to ready position with proper posture. Now go to playing position. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Go to ready position. Did you get a sound? As you move your air, be certain your lips are touching and your embouchure is set. Let's try this one more time. Get set in playing position. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Go to ready position. It is important that you do not press the mouthpiece against your lips with too much pressure. This could make it difficult for your lips to vibrate. Use just enough gentle pressure that the rim of the mouthpiece seals against your lips. Try this one more time with Katie. Remember to sit with proper posture and take a full breath. Go to playing position. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Did you get a sound? There are a number of sounds that you can get in this position. Listen as Katie demonstrates several of them. This is a C. This is an E. This is a G. You might be getting any one of these. At the moment, as long as you are getting one of these three pitches, that's great. Later, you can work to get each pitch separately. Try that one more time with Katie. Get set in playing position. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Go to ready position. Be sure that you have an open sound. Do not push up with your chin, and do not pinch your lips together. This will create a poor or pinched tone quality. Listen again as Katie demonstrates a proper horn sound for you. Practice again with Katie. Go to playing position. 1, 2, ready, breathe. Go to ready position. Now you can practice getting your first horn sounds on your own. Each time you practice this exercise, concentrate on one of these essential elements of brass playing. Make sure your mouthpiece is placed correctly. Be sure to take a full and proper breath. Keep your teeth open to allow the air to flow freely. Work to remove any air pockets between your cheeks and the gums of your upper and lower teeth. Work to have a smooth chin. Be sure you allow your lips to vibrate freely with no pressure. Keep your air speed and embouchure steady. Work on these aspects of tone production daily to get the best sound possible on your horn.